Hey guys, REPULSE here with some more Monster Hunter World Iceborne news. And this one, we're taking a look at a Japanese TV commercial for Monster Hunter World. It's a short one, so I'll leave a link in the description below so you can check it out for yourself. So let's get right into it. To start off, we see a Baryoth take on a Bambro. This, I believe, is part of the turf war we have seen before, and Baryoth just rolls through Bambro. And it looks really awesome, and I cannot wait to see it in full. Also, we see in this little clip, we see that the hunter is wearing a full Rathian armor set, as well as the Rathian sword. Well, longsword, I should say. And it does look pretty sweet. Hopefully, the armor has pretty decent skills on it. So, yeah, moving on to the next one, which is pretty cool. It moves on to another turf war between Tigrex and Brachydios. And this does look good, and it looks like it will be a draw as they are both strong monsters. And it also confirms that Tigrex will be a wandering monster. And I'm sure if this has been confirmed or not, I don't know if it has or it hasn't, but we now know that it's going to be in Elder's Recess as well. During this little clip, the hunter is wearing Nagakuga set as well as a pair of jewel blades. I'm not sure if they are just Nagakuga ones or they're just normal steel ones. That's yet to be seen. But yeah, that's Naga. It may be pretty cool. Hopefully, I guess. But I kind of don't see if this is going to be a draw or not. I don't know. I'm pretty sure Brachydios will end up one-banging Tigrex. Who knows? We'll have to see. It's very close. Very, 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 very close. Then we see a little bit of a Nagakuga chasing a hunter. This hunter is wearing full Glavinus set, and I think that it could be a switch axe. I could be wrong. It could be totally something different, but I believe it is a switch axe. It does resemble like the switch axe kind of thing, and I think that might be the Glavinus switch axe behind the hunter, but we'll have to wait and see and find out for ourselves. In this clip, we see a Baryoth jump from the wall to the hunter. In this clip, the hunter is wearing the Glavinus set. The Glavinus set is being featured in this a lot, and behind him, well, the hunter has equipped, I believe, an insect glaive. Well, obviously, because I saw the kinsect on the arm. And it could be either the Brachydios insect glaive or it could be the Glavinus. I would say it's probably Glavinus because Brachydios weapons has that green tinge to it, like the slime blast. So I could be right with the insect glaive being the Glavinus one. So we're gonna have to check that when the game comes out. I could be completely wrong. Who knows? It could be Brachydios' one. But yeah, for now I'm gonna say it's Glavinus. Moving on, we see Glavinus doing his 360 move to hit hunters around. We also get a good look at the Baryoth armor set. This does look pretty cool, with like the horns on top of, well, I guess it's his fangs that are on top of the hunter's head. We also get to see the longsword of the Baryoth, so that's pretty cool. It does look pretty decent. I assume that it would be, I guess, ice attack maybe, but who knows? We'll have to wait and see. Then we get to see a small little clip of a hunter blocking a Brachydios punch to the face. This hunter is wearing a full Tigrex gear. We've seen this before. We just get a little bit more of a good look of it. This hunter is also equipped with a sword and shield. I'm not entirely sure if this is the Tigrex sword and shield, but it could be just a regular sword and shield. I don't know. I want to say it's a Tigrex sword and shield because maybe, I don't know. But we'll have to wait and see to actually take a look at that. But I think it might be just Tigrex's sun shield, maybe just a normal iron shield. Then we get to see a new monster that has been in past games, and that is Rathian's love child, Yian Garuga. This monster looks great in HD. He also makes a great start by using its tail to uppercut Devil Joe in the face. This monster does love to scream. a lot, so make sure to bring your earplugs, as this is going to be a fun and interesting fight. Moving on, we see a hunter in full Glavinus gear once again, with what I could see is maybe Glavinus's insect glaive, or it could be the Brachydeus one. You don't really see much of it, as the hunter is then hidden by Barov's head. There's not much more I can say about that, so I guess moving on. Then we see the Bambaro bow. That does look awesome. Cannot wait to use the bow, or any of the new bows that are coming. I was an insect glaive user, but I kind of got bored of it, so bow is my new weapon of choice. So I cannot wait to try out all the new bows that will be coming shortly. Now we get to see a good look at what the Brachydeus armor will look like, plus his hammer. Hammer does look very good. I'm hoping Capcom stay true to Brachydeus's wacky designs with the green tinge with the blackness on them for all their weapons. We'll have to wait and see if that holds up. Who knows, could be completely wrong, but I'm hoping they stay with the black and green, because that does look very nice. To end the video, we get another look at Vel'Koz, still looking great. Cannot wait to fight them all. They look so good. We don't have much to go till we get our hands on the game. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe for more Monster Hunter coming your way very soon. And I'll see you in the next one.